Hello children, I hope you all are fine and trying to complete your assignment on time. Students, wherever you are, remember this. You are precious. You are loved. You have the talent. You have the good character. Therefore, have courage, be kind, stay humble. Have faith, focus on your study and do your best. So, children, today in that expectation, we are going to continue our 8th chapter, algebraic expressions and operation on them. So, children, in our exercise 34, we are going to study subtraction. So, in exercise 33 and 32, we had completed the terms related to monomial, binomial and trinomial and polynomial. I hope you all understood that. After that, we had learned to adding binomial terms and trinomial terms. So today we are going to continue but that binomial and trinomial in subtraction method. So children, in our exercise 34, question number first one is given, subtract the second expression from the first. So children, question is given, 4xy minus 9z. Second term, 3xy minus 16z. Here, one more thing, it's given that subtract second expression from the first. And this same sum I will give in both method, horizontal method as well as vertical method. So children, here, first one, horizontal method. Horizontal method. 4xy minus 9z, we will write in one bracket. Next one, minus 3xy minus 16z. So children, you all can observe between both these binomial terms, I had put subtraction sign. So children, when we will remove the bracket, that time some changes will be there. First term before subtraction sign, the terms will add it is 4xy minus 9z. But after subtraction, the sign of all the term, it will change. For example, 3xy, it is in plus sign. But when we will remove the bracket, the sign of 3xy, which one is in plus, that one will be minus. Therefore, minus 3xy. Here, minus sign is there, it will be plus 16z. Next one, we will add or subtract like term with like term. Therefore, xy, where else we all are seeing xy, xy. So, 4xy minus 3xy. Again, minus 9z plus 16z. Means xy term together and z term together. So children, here 4 minus 3. Because greater number is having plus sign. Therefore 4 minus 3, 1xy. 1xy. If you want, then write 1. Otherwise, no need to write 1. Xy you have written. Means it is understood that is 1 is there. Next term, minus 9z. plus 16j. Which number is greater than 16? And 16 is having plus sign. Therefore, we will write greater number, that is 16 minus 9. 16 minus 9, 7. 7j. Now, 16 is having plus sign. Therefore, put plus sign with 7j. I hope you all understood. Now, same question we will solve with the help of vertical method. Here, 4xy minus 9z. This one is vertical method. Vertical method. 4xy minus 9z. Here, subtraction, that's why we will put minus sign. Next term, 3xy. We will, while writing second binomial, we will see the like term first. For example, xy. Where is xy? Xy is here. Write down of that xy and minus 16z. So children, subtraction. When I have taught you this one, addition, that time we had not changed the sign. But here this one is subtraction. That's why the binomial, all the sign will change. For example, 3 is positive, it will be minus sign. Next one, this one is minus, it will be plus. If you want, then put in bracket. If you don't want, you can rough the bracket. So, now you are going to consider the new sign for the number. Here, 9 is minus sign, 16 is in plus sign. Then 16 minus 9, you will get 7z. And 16 is carrying plus sign, therefore plus 7z. 4 minus 3, 1xy. I already told, if you want, write 1. Otherwise, no need to write 1. Write down xy. Answer is xy plus 7z. So, we will move further, that is question number second one. Question number second. Trinomial given 5x plus 4y plus 7z. Next term, x plus 2y plus 3z. So, first method, horizontal method. I hope when you will solve, you will also solve by both the method. Horizontal method. Horizontal method. Here, 5x plus 4y 7z. In one bracket, in other bracket, x plus 2y plus 3z. First term before minus sign, all the term sign will be as it is. Write down 5x plus 4y plus 7z. But after minus sign, all the terms sign will change. Minus x minus 2y minus 3z. Next term, when you are writing, next step, like term, write down with like term. For example, 5x and minus x. Write together 5x minus x, 4y with 2y plus 4y minus 2y plus 7z minus 3z. Here, we had completed with like term. 5 minus 1, x minus x, with x 1 is there. Therefore, 5 minus 1, 4. 4x. 5 is in plus, therefore 4 will also carry plus sign. Here, 4y minus 2y, 4 minus 2, 2y. Greater number is carrying plus sign. Therefore, with your answer, plus. Next one, 7 minus 3, 4z. Greater number is carrying plus sign. Therefore, with your answer, plus. Your answer, 4x plus 2y plus 4z. Now same sum we will solve by vertical method. Vertical method 5x 4y plus 7z. Vertical method. Then while writing second term, we will write like term down of that like term. Put minus sign x right here plus 2y plus 3z. Subtraction sign, therefore all the term will change its sign. Therefore 7, now 3 is having minus sign. Therefore 7 minus 3, 4z, 4 minus 2, 2y, here 4 is having plus sign because greater number is carrying plus sign, that's why. Here also greater number is 4 and 4 is having plus sign, therefore plus. Here 5 minus 1, answer 4x. I hope both the sum and both the method also you all understood. So children, we will solve next two question, third one. Question number third one, 14 x square plus 8 xy plus 3 y square. Second one is given, 26 x square minus 8 xy minus 17 y square and bracket close. So children, first method, horizontal method. Horizontal method. Here while writing first bracket, we will write as it is. Before writing second bracket, we will put minus sign in between both. Then 26 x square minus 8 xy minus 17 y square. Now second step, when we are writing first bracket, we'll write as it is. For example, 14 x square 8 xy 3 y square. When we are writing second bracket, before removing bracket, we will change the sign also. 26 is carrying plus sign. When we will remove sign, therefore minus plus minus 26 x square minus minus plus 8 xy and here minus minus plus 17 y square. We are multiplying the sign minus into plus minus. Or in easiest way, suppose before bracket minus sign is there, then all the terms sign is changing. For example, plus, we are writing minus, minus will be plus, minus will be plus. Now next step, when we are writing like term, we will write together. For example, 14 x square, where else is there x square, minus 26 x square. Next one, xy, we will write with xy. 8xy plus 8xy. Next term, 3y square plus 17y square. Again, 14 and minus 26. Greater number is 26. 26 minus 14. 6 minus 4, that is, both the number is having opposite sign. 14 is having plus sign, 26 is having minus sign. Therefore 6 minus 4, 2, 2 minus 1, 1, 12 x square. Now 26 is carrying minus sign, therefore with your answer you put minus sign. Next one, 8 xy plus 8 xy, both is carrying same sign, that is plus plus. Therefore, easiest to add. 8 plus 8, 16 xy. Next one, 3 y square plus 17 y square. This one is also, both the number is carrying same sign, that is plus. Therefore, add both the numbers, 17 plus 3, 20 y square. Your answer is minus 12 x square plus 16 xy plus 20 y square. Now, same sum we will solve by vertical method. So, children, while writing in vertical method, first term write as it is, 14 x square, 8 xy plus 3 y square. But before writing second term, first you have to observe that like term you have to write in the down of like term only. Therefore, here minus sign and 26 x square, right, down of 14 x square, minus 8 xy, minus 17 y square. Next one, minus sign, therefore all the term will change the sign. Here plus, therefore minus. Here minus, therefore plus. Minus, it will change into plus. Now 17 is in plus. New sign we are going to look. 17 plus 3, 20 y square. Both is having plus sign. Next one, 8 plus 8, 16 xy. Both number is carrying plus sign. Therefore, put plus sign. 26 minus 4, 14. That is 6 minus 4, 2. 2 minus 1, 1. 12 x square. But here, greater number is carrying minus sign. Therefore, put minus sign. I hope you all understood. And in both method, our answer is same only. So children, I hope related to exercise 34, you all understood the sum. Now, we are going to move further to our exercise 35. In our exercise 35, given multiply. Question number first. First given multiply. 16xy into 18xy. So children, 16 into 18. First we will write the numbers, that is 16 into 18. Simplify the numbers multiplication first. Afterward, x into y, x into y, then into x into y. Means multiplication of all term we had done. 16 we had written as it is, 18 we had written as it is. After that, xy, x into y, xy, x into y. Next one, we will multiply 16 into 18. 8, 6 are 48. 8, 1 is 8, 8 plus 4, 12, 1 into 6, 6, 1 into 1, 1, 8, 8, 2. Means when we multiply it, 16 into 18, we got 288. Rough this one, 288, then x and x, how many times x is there, 1 and 2. Write down x and square, 1 and 2. Next one, y. Y, how many times y is there? 1 and 2. Add both this, then y square means multiplying. And when multiplication is there, what we are doing? We are adding the index. Means here y raised to 1, y raised to 1. Then total y raised to 2, that is y square. So children, our answer is 288 x square and y square. Now second question. Second question, 23 x y square. Y square. Next one. Plus into 4 y z square, 23 x y square plus 4 y z square, y z square. So children, as I told you, first we will complete multiplication of number 23 into 4. Next term I told x, if you want, you write all the things together, x into y square into y and into z square. If you want, together also xy square into yz square also you can write. Now 4 3 jar 12, 4 2 jar 8, 1 9, 92. X how many times? Only one time. Write x. Y how many times given? Y square into y 1. Nothing is y raised to, nothing is given. Means there 1 is there. That is y square into y 1. Therefore y cube and z square. Only x and z square. X is having one term, that is same we had written. Z square also having one term. That's why it's also we had written single term, that is z square. Now your answer is 92 x y cube z square. So children, next question we will solve. Which one is given? Binomial multiply by monomial. Third question. Question number third. Third is given 12a plus 17b into 4c. Binomial, now we are going to multiply by monomial. So children, 12a first term into given term, that is 4c. This bracket first we are going to remove, and before removing this bracket, 12a plus 17b, 12a multiply by 4c, in between plus sign, second term is 17b multiply by 4c. Means with this bracket, with both the term, we are multiplying with 4c, which one is given outside. So children, 12, 4 jar 48, a into c, that is ac. Next one, 17 into 4, 68, and here b and c. So children, I hope you all understood. Now we are going to solve question number fourth one. Fourth one, 4x plus 5y. Next one is multiply by 9x plus 7y. So children, here also what we will do? First step, that is first bracket, we will write as it is and multiply by second bracket first term. Again, first bracket we will write as it is, multiply by with this 7y we will multiply. For example, 4x plus 5y multiply by 9x. If you want, you write here also in left side. If you want, you can write with right side also. Now in between plus sign, again 4x plus 5y bracket close into 7y. Means with this bracket we multiply one time with 9x and other time with 7y. What you will do? 4x into 9x means 4x multiply by 9x. When we will remove the bracket, 5y multiply by 9x. Again, 4x multiply by 7y plus 5y multiply by 7y. Next one. Now you all can observe all this number. 4 into 9, 36x, 2 time is there. Therefore, x square, x1, x1. Means x raised to 1, x raised to 1. 1, 1, 2. 1 plus 1, 2. Next one, 5, 9, 45. Next one, x, here different variables are there. X, y, means x, y. Next one, 4, 7 are 28. Here also different variables are there. X into Y, that is X Y together we had written. Next one 5, 7 are 35. Here same variable y raised to 1. Therefore 1 plus 1, 2. Write down y square. So our answer is 36x² + 45xy + 28xy + 35y². So children, our next question, that is question is given. A rectangle is having length 8x + 5 and breadth 5x + 3. Length is given 8x + 5. Breadth is given, or that is broad is given. Broad or breadth you can write. This one is given 5x + 3. So it is asking, that is area of the rectangle. Write down area of a rectangle equal to length into breadth. Then length into breadth. Length is given 8x + 5. Breadth is given 5x + 3. In between both, multiplication sign is there. Then what you will do? As I had shown you in question number 4th one, you will solve the same method. 8x + 5, we will write as it is. Multiply by 5x, first term. Again, in between, plus sign is there. 8x + 5, multiply by 3. So children, 8 into 5 + 5 into 5x + 8x into 3 + 5 into 3. 8 into 5, 40. x into x, x square + 5 into 5, 25x + 8 3 are 24x + 5 3 are 15. So children, here 40x² 25 + 24, that is 49x + 15. Here this one, what you will write? Here centimeter given. This one is centimeter, this one is centimeter. Therefore you will write square centimeter, means 2 times. Therefore square centimeter. So children, today we have completed exercise 34 and 35. I hope you all understood. Suppose any doubt is there, you can clear with subject teacher. So children, complete your assignment. Take care of yourself. Be happy. Thank you.